We gather together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Welcome to all of you for this Easter celebration. Warm welcome to all those who are watching, praying along on the internet. Jesus is risen. Easter reminds us life is stronger than death. So as we gather to celebrate this mystery, let's take a moment in silence, pray for God's mercy, God's healing power, and God's life. I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do,
through my most grievous fault.
Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us into life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who on this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what was happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him, all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. The right hand of the Lord has struck with power. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. I shall not die, but live and declare the works of the Lord. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, if then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, your life, appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sons and daughters, let us sing. The King of Heaven, the glorious King, o'er death today he rose triumphing. Alleluia. That Easter morn at break of day, the faithful women went their way to seek the tomb where Jesus lay. Alleluia. An angel clad in white they see, who sat and spoke unto the three. Your Lord has gone to Galilee. Alleluia. On this most holy day of days, to God your hearts and voices raise, in laud and jubilee and praise. Alleluia.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Christ, our Paschal Lamb, has been sacrificed. Let us then feast with joy in the Lord. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning, while it was still dark, and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved, and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter, and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloth there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloth there, and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloth, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. For they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
There is an old Chinese drama movie titled To Live. Some of you might have saw it before. But the simple story is, two soldiers survived a horrible war. After the war, they came back to their ordinary lives. But the experience of the war helped them to appreciate their lives much more. So the central idea of the movie is, to live is not easy. We have to live well. Appreciate life, have hope for eternal life. Isn't this the message of Easter? Jesus is alive. He wants us to have life. This is the heart of our Easter celebration. On the first day of the week, early in the morning, the disciples went to look for Jesus. They went to the tomb. Mary of Magdala was there first. It's a new day. Something new is going to happen. And they were hoping that Jesus was still in the tomb. But to her surprise, something truly happened in the tomb. The tomb was empty. She went back and told the other disciples, Peter and the beloved disciple came. Peter came first, but the beloved disciple saw the empty tomb and believed. He believed first. The same empty tomb, different reactions. They didn't understand the scripture yet. but they were ready to believe that Jesus is alive. Their fears began to disappear. They began to wonder what this new life might look like, what resurrection is about. He saw it and believed. And we know later on how all the disciples believed in this mystery and gave their lives to witness for Jesus. We too, because of this mystery of the resurrection of our Savior, our lives are different. Jesus paid the price for us. We now have hope for eternal life. This faith calls us to give life to others. In the first reading, we heard from Peter, the Acts of Apostles, how Peter went out to preach about Jesus' life, death, and the resurrection. He told people that he ate, drank with Jesus while he was alive. After 3 days in the tomb, now Jesus is alive in a different way. Because of his preaching, his witness, his testimony, many came to believe in Jesus. They began to have life, life in the risen Lord. That's what we are called to do too, to give life to others after we have received life from the risen Lord. We have experienced transformation by the power of the resurrection of Jesus. This Easter, unlike any other Easter, we are physically isolated. We are not able to celebrate the mystery of Jesus' resurrection together as a community. It makes it hard, but at the same time, to me, it's very challenging and more meaningful. We have to ask ourselves, where and how do we experience the risen life of our Savior in our everyday lives, particularly during this pandemic? Well, we know there are too much physical death, too much fear out there. But the Easter message is very hopeful to us. Love is stronger than fear. Life is stronger than death. This message keeps us going. This message helps us to love others, to give life to others. And we know there are countless people who are doing it. Think of the medical staff who risk their lives to save others. Think of the parents who lost their jobs, yet they are willing to do everything they can to provide for their children, for their family. Think of the compassion expressed by countless ordinary people in our world today through their financial sacrifice or material donations to end this pandemic. Easter calls us to receive love, to receive life, and to share love and life with others. So this Easter, when you gather around with your family, sharing a delicious meal, be grateful to one another and to our God. Say a prayer for those who are suffering. so that the end of this crisis can come soon. This Easter, let's renew our faith that life is worthy living, that we have hope for eternal life. Let's renew our commitment to give life to others, to live. It's not easy. So we have to appreciate life and all life. Easter life offers us hope, encouragement, inspiration, fortitude, and strength to persevere, to give life to others, and to have hope for eternal life. Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so now, let us renew the promises of holy baptism, by which we once renounced Satan and his works, and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. So now I ask you, brothers and sisters, do you renounce Satan?
I do.
And all his works?
I do.
And all his empty promises?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only begotten Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of sins, the forgiveness of sin, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting?
I do.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen. Trusting that God is with us, God loves us, let's now raise our voices of needs for ourselves and for others into the merciful hands of our Heavenly Father.
Our response will be, Risen Lord, hear our prayer. For the living church, may we witness to the joyful truth of the resurrection quietly and safely at home during the COVID-19 crisis. We pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of nations and communities, may the Easter Alleluia strengthen and direct them to use their power to protect the poor, help the homeless, and coordinate efforts to combat COVID-19. We pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For all parishioners, friends, school children, and families of St. Mother Teresa Parish, may the Easter life give us renewed hope and inner peace and unity. We pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For those preparing to receive the Easter sacraments at a later date, that they may enter more deeply into the mystery of God's unconditional love, we pray.
Risen Lord,
for those who care for the sick and dying in our medical field, that access to vital safety equipment and critical medical supplies are made available very soon. We pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For workers, businesses, and restaurant owners who are suffering economic hardship due to COVID-19, that they may be strengthened in faith, hope, and love during this Holy Week, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who we remember at this Mass, especially Anna Lopez, Anicita Canleon Galdo and family, Anicito Saludo Sr., Virginia Pienta, Deacon Andy Brongiel, Gladys Kaminsky, Russell Leon, Mary Diaz De Leon, Ted and Stan Pirecki, Jimmy Anareno, Henry Yong, Helen Moy, Phyllis Centofanti, Albert Wong, Lena Rohde, Dominic Barbaro, Sao Fong Yan, Cookie and David Jarzina, all deceased family members of Marion Rohde, Benny Chan, Jen Ping J. Chan, Diane Marie Chan, Gordon Lee, Joe Lee Shu, Daisy Doranilla, and Vincent Briglio. For all these we pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
Risen Lord, hear the prayers of your faithful people. Increase our hope, life, and love in you. We ask all those prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now the green plate rises from the buried grain. We eat that in dark earth many days has lain. Love lives again that with the dead has been. Love is come again like wheat arising green. When our hearts are wintry, grieving or in pain, your touch can call us back to life again. Fields of our hearts that dead and bare have been. Love is come again like wheat arising green.
Lord, worship me.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the whole of his holy church.
Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We have lifted them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day above all, to laud you yet more gloriously. When Christ our Passover has been sacrificed, for he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, Jesus has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalt your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as we now acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and gave you thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more gave you thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Blaise, our Bishop, and all other bishops, priests, religious, and all of your faithful people. Remember also all of our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Saint Joseph, her chaste spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Barbara, Saint Teresa of the Little Flower, Saint Mother Teresa of Calcutta, Saint Rocco, and all of your saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. We are God's beloved children. How blessed we are. So with humble and hopeful hearts, let's now praise our Heavenly Father using the words our risen Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you shall enter under my roof, but only say a word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and the blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Thank you for celebrating this Easter with us. Special thanks to all those who are watching you praying along the Easter Sunday Mass on internet. In this difficult time, we truly, really need the Easter message. Jesus is alive, and we are promised of eternal life. Life is stronger than death. So may your celebration, your gathering with families on this Easter, bring you much needed hope, life, and peace. May the risen Lord bless all of you, your family, and your loved ones. May the risen Lord bring much God's healing power upon all those who are suffering, those who are helping to end the COVID-19 crisis. May the risen Lord give us renewed life, love, compassion for all. Let us pray. Look upon your church, O Lord, with unfailing care and love, so that renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia.
Sing